Starting in 3ds Max 2018 Update 2, or 2018.2 as it is known, you can enjoy a series of spline tools improvements that you'll find quite rewarding. For starters, there's a new freehand tool in the splines creation panel that enables you to create splines in, wait for it, freehand mode. As you draw strokes in the viewport, 3ds Max adds the necessary vertex points or knots to create a spline that follows your hand stroke. The properties seen in the modify panel enable you to see these knots, among other parameters that you can adjust. For example, you can adjust the sampling value to change the number of knots. Still, this option doesn't necessarily give you the best control over topology and shape. This is where a series of new spline modifiers become handy. Let's start with the spline relax modifier, not to be confused with the relax modifier that does no good when applied to a spline. Instead, make sure you use the spline relax modifier, which, as the name implies, is specifically written for spline objects. Keep that in mind, as the new spline modifier tools all start or end with the word spline, such as spline relax or normalize spline. With spline relax, again, you have the option of showing the knots. In some cases, you may need a viewport refresh. Simply slide the animation slider bar to that effect. As the name implies, Spline Relax relaxes the spline without changing the topology. This is done by editing the amount and iterations values. It keeps the same number of knots, but changes their placement in order to smooth the spline. This can be particularly useful with freehand splines. If you need to reduce the number of knots, you may want to look at the Optimize Spline modifier. As with Spline Relax, you can show the knots, but now you can strip down their numbers in a variety of methods. The default method works in percentage mode, and you can see the effect on the number of knots on the spline as you raise this value. In this case, we are able to reduce the number of knots by 90%, down to 11 knots instead of the original 112, without deforming the shape. Sometimes, you need to do the opposite. In some cases, you need to add knots instead of deleting them. The normalized spline helps in that regard. Here, you have many options to work with. Start by disabling and enabling the modifier to compare with what's below in the stack. Normalized spline is adding vertices or knots based on a default segment length of 20. This means the knots are now equidistant from one another. By changing the distance value, you can have more or less knots, depending on what the project needs. Another method of normalizing is to simply specify a knot count. This can be useful for morphing, where vertex count is crucial. There's one additional option that you may find useful, the Insert option. Enable it first, and for the time being, disable the Weighted option. I'll explain about this one in just a moment. Disable and enable the modifier so that you can appreciate what this method of work does for you. In fact, what this procedure does is very similar to the divide option in editable splines. It adds a vertex between two others, in effect dividing segments by a number that you choose, the default being 1. This may be useful in its own right, but typically, the concept of normalizing is to make vertices a bit more equidistant. This is where the weighted option comes in. Without it, note in this case the middle part of the ampersand. Initially, it has two knots placed quite far from each other. Using normalize insert mode without the weighted option adds one more knot, but the distance is still too great. With weighted enabled, this method will add more knots only where needed. It will adapt to divide those edges more or less to provide better topology that you can work with. Next, I'll discuss spline overlap, but to be able to appreciate that feature, you'll need a more detailed spline, so make sure you add a few more knots first. Add a spline overlap modifier. Its thickness value is of most interest, as it enables you to raise a spline where segments overlap. you may want to enable the geometry on the base spline level in order to see the overlap effect better. Adjust the thickness and drape values to your liking. This could be a cool effect to use on ropes. I'll end this lesson with one more useful modifier, spline mirror. Spline mirror is for splines what the symmetry modifier is for geometry. It lets you easily create some interesting shapes like this arabesque that would take significantly longer to create using other methods. Let's try it. Create a rectangle in the front view of about 100 in length and 50 in width. Place it in the center of the scene above the ground. You will use it to create the star-like effect of the arabesque. You could use a star shape, but the method you're about to use will make it easier to introduce changes should you need them. Convert the rectangle to an editable spline and chamfer its upper vertices. Exit sub-object mode when done. Next, add the spline mirror modifier. Like with the symmetry modifier, you need to relocate the mirror line. Move the mirror line to the base of the rectangle and rotate minus 15 degrees using angle snap, A on the keyboard. Use the flip option to see the results stretching to the right. Copy the spline mirror modifier and paste it to the top of the stack. Rotate the mirror line an additional 30 degrees. Repeat the procedure two more times to complete the star. As mentioned, this method of working makes it easy to go back and edit the original spline to affect the star as a whole. Ultimately, you can add a sweep modifier to give the shape depth and geometry. The rest of the arabesque can be built similarly. If you look closely, you can see a pattern developing with a rotating square. Create a square in the front view that's about 100 by 100 in size. Place it in the top left corner at minus 70 in X and plus 70 in Z. Apply a spline mirror modifier and place the mirror line in the center of the scene as earlier at 000. As earlier, you will need to enable the flip option to see the end result. Rotate the mirror line 30 degrees. Note that by default, the result is trimmed based on the mirror line. This option worked when we created the star earlier, but does not work here. Disable the option Slice Along Mirror to fix that problem. Copy-paste the modifier as you did before, and rotate the mirror line by minus 30 degrees. Before you repeat the next procedure, there's a bit of warning to be made here. Because you disabled Slice Along Mirror, you have to be careful of overlapping splines. If you rotate the mirror line and end up with overlapping shapes, then these overlapping segments would remain at the end and add to the resulting geometry. So you may need to plan this a bit better as you're building your components. In this case, you could add an Edit Spline modifier, and at the spline level, you can select and delete the last rectangle. Now, if you copy and paste the last spline mirror modifier, you can rotate the mirror line another 30 degrees to go from 3 shapes to 6 without any overlapping edges. You can then copy-paste the final spline mirror modifier and give it another 90-degree rotation to finalize the shape. From this point on, you can finalize the design by having a little fun. You could add an edit spline modifier to the original square and adjust it. You could also potentially add a frame as a finishing touch, or collapse the splines altogether for further editing. In the case of the arabesque shown here, they would collapse the spline object before applying the sweep modifier. This allowed them to be trimmed to fit inside the square frame. In the example of the metal design, a normalized spline and a spline overlap modifiers were used for the final effect.